Justin Tucker all set, and we are set to see the cream of the crop in the AFC as we are underway here with the Ravens and the Chiefs. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Now the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And not the start he was hoping for there, as he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Jordan Richards the one there to bring him down.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And oh, right away, he lost the football. But it looks like the Chiefs are going to get it back. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So danger averted for the moment, but now here's a third and long. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow them to convert a third and 18.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. And we're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact and he'll go deep.
Big Calais Campbell fighting through to make the play in the backfield.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Now on second and 13, Mahomes escaping the pressure right. He'll swing this one out to Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 39. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. He'll find Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Not much there, only a yard.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
I think you can make a fair.
Tyreek Hill being the most explosive player in the NFL when he gets his hands on the football, and that was Exhibit A.
And I'll tell you what a bird's eye view I've got here, because That was absolutely something else to watch. Not a lot of wiggle in that. That was catch it and go, and to use those heels of his, absolute devastating effect.
And if you look at the next-gen stats, you'll see that he topped out at an even 21 miles an hour.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the six.
Chris Jones on the stop. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight at the 6 yard line.
We're scoreless after one.
With no score.
Raven football here as we begin quarter number two, as they've got a second and eight forthcoming. And here's Jackson on the option, and he will lose yardage here back to his own six. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher, third down and nine.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is just going to gang up on the run and shut them down.
On third down, Jackson. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And down inside the red zone at the 19-yard line.
All the practice, all the training, all the meetings. In this situation, I know exactly what quarterbacks are taught. Take care of the football. That's job one paramount. Because you cough it up here, you might be giving up 6 points real easy.
Tip of the cap to the defense, though, forcing the fumble. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Chief linemen might have moved. The false start backs him up five, first and 15. Mahomes now to throw. That one complete to Hill. Give him six on the play, and that'll make it a second down. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts, and still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. On On second down, here's the option.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. Looking to throw is Mahomes. That is caught at the seven. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And they'll try the option on first and goal.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
Made a great read there, CD. Good decision to keep it.
And I think what we just saw there is someone understanding that throwing the ball through that traffic can also be fraught with disaster. Keep it, use your legs, get into the end zone.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And his kick is good to make it 7-0 KC.
Score, Chiefs 7, Ravens nothing.
Touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away.
Fielded in the end zone.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
They're going option play on third down.
Flushed out right. First down and more for Jackson. And he's going to get this to the 40-yard line. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
That's a nice explosive play there, and this defense told us we have to have our eyes right on their RPO sets, and they did not have their eyes right.
I love that term, eyes right, meaning they have to be in the proper place and read your keys. And a smart thinking guy running an offense can see when you break down on that, and he took full advantage of it.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41.
Well, every now and then, we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your best ability is often your availability. And this is an extremely durable kid coming out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses. And
looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now Mahomes to the line as the Chiefs are going to go for the two-point try. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. And they turn the pick six into a pick eight with that two-point conversion.
I love how you upset. That is outstanding right there. What a big-time play. Big switch in how this game was going. And then they capitalize a little bit on top.
taken in the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score.
And oh, he coughed it up, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
Now after the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes eluding the pressure right. Mahomes hit, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Ravens. The defense, they were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on, so much swirling around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around to find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing. Take care of the football.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. A new life now following the late turnover. Maybe a chance for points here before the break.
Yeah, pretty nice situation they find themselves in because they're really maybe one completion away from giving their kicker a shot. And that gives them a chance to get some points up on the board.
He'll try and run it. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. The play fake to Dobbins. Here's Jackson. He'll find Dobbins out of the backfield. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Here's Justin Tucker now for the Raven field goal try. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And they're on the board now. It's 15-3. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And last time, the fumble, the turnover. Now they still have the lead, but I don't think coaches care. The turnovers will bother them no matter what the scoreboard says.
That's the relief, that you still have the lead. But coaches look at what if and what it should be. Turning the ball over when they've got a chance to score more points and increase the lead, that's what's going to affect them.
And they're also thinking to future weeks, maybe when the game's closer, right?
No doubt about it. You want to clean up everything. Let's just be honest about it. They want everything to be perfect at all times. They don't want to give up anything that's going to hurt their team.
Looking for Hill again. This time it's complete. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
44-yard line.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. Sammy Watkins, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. final shot before the half for Mahomes.
And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we come upon halftime in what's a 12-point game at the break. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. And that's fielded on the back line of the end zone. Set at the line for this next drive. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
Another run here with Dobbins. And he's got Rome. And nothing but daylight ahead. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, 70 yards. And the Ravens draw a bit closer. Well, we have seen some rookie running backs come in and have a big impact year one, and this guy would certainly fit that bill, as that was one heck of a run there. Justin Tucker for the extra point. It through, that makes it a 5-point ball game. It's 15-10 now.
Chiefs 15, Ravens 10. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. Up past the 20 of the 22-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Mahomes now on first down. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Kansas City Chiefs. First and 10 at the 30.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Mahomes picked by his ex-teammate Marcus Peters. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Now Jackson, apparently a little unsure of things, so he'll call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. After the interception, here's Jackson. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. It's Dobbins, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Chris Jones that time coming in with a tackle behind the line. On second and 15 now, Jackson being chased out left. Looking left side, Andrews with it complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time. On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Right back to Dobbins on first. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. The linebacker Anthony Hitchens there on the stop.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Play action. Now Jackson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
An incomplete pass on second down. That'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson rolling to his left. He may try and run for this. And he is going to get the first down as he covers up after a pretty good shot there. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. They'll try to run with Dobbins. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens have taken the lead. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd? And they asked about halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said, it's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case. And
of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
Yeah, my bad.
John Harbaugh thought about it, and now his guys are going to go for the 2-point conversion. From the gun, it's Jackson. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it will stay at 1.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for 2 too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up 2, right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for 2 here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
Tucker, the kickoff for Baltimore. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Their own 23-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They had that lead that is now gone. It is completely gone. How does that affect the psyche? Am I reading into that too much? They should be okay still?
No, you're not reading into it too much at all. You've got to wonder what the psyche is of a team, because once you build up a lead and things are rolling pretty well, you don't expect it to change. And for it to change this dramatically, and now they're the team doing the chasing, yeah, you want to check out where they are mentally and whether or not they have it in them to come back. We'll soon find out.
Yeah, they're on their heels a bit right now. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Mahomes going to throw. Flush to his right. And now he's going to use his legs. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for 26 and a first down. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. So, boy, that's already the third they burn here. They are out of timeouts now before we've even hit the fourth quarter. First down, Mahomes. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Matt Judon able to put an end to that play, and in so doing, puts an end to this third quarter. We're back now in KC. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Looking for Kelce there, but it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. Breaks the tackle, now Riley. The 20. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. Boy, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Right, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now it's Jackson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. The 30. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides, so I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
Well, it's my kind of game. You know that.
Anytime we have a defensive battle,
but that, as you said, it stands to reason that's the way the game tilted. Someone had to make a big play, and the way the defenses were dominating, that's exactly what we got.
And it is incomplete, so they can't convert for two. And now the lead stays at 5.
Ravens 16. Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Boy, a bad break. Just got the lead on the touchdown. And now they're going to have to go on defense at the 40-yard line here as things get good in the fourth quarter. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Check, 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 check. Jackson on the give to Dobbins.
And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That's a play to take note of there for the defense. I think in the future, if you're going to try and block him, maybe you get a guard to help double team him and try and steer him out of the play. They should have done it on that snap.
Second and 12. Jackson steps away. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
To throw is Jackson on third down. Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off by the 37. And they're going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
She's been one mistake after another on the offensive side of the ball. That's now 3 interceptions to go along with 2 fumbles for him. And if you're going to turn the ball over 5 times in a game, your chances to win have to be about 100-1. And it's not looking good for him here.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage.
Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 19.
Well, they're not making it easy on themselves here down the stretch. 2 picks now in the fourth quarter trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Lamar Jackson, for all the talents of escaping pressure that he possesses, he was helpless to do much of anything there. He had no chance.
And this came from the interior of the defensive line, and these guys, they're normally anchors of that spot, and they don't often get clear shots at the quarterback. But in this case, he got past the center and the guard in no time and got there to make the play.
And the final clocking there, according to Next Gen Stats, that sack occurred in 2.2 seconds. So the pass rush, overwhelming that time. Timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. And that'll set them back 5.
That's what I'm talking about. Self on deck, baby. Fuck,
you can't stop me. On second down, Jackson escaping the pressure right. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15.
Jackson 3. Let's get that.
here's Jackson. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
J.K. Dobbins, the one he was looking for.
That'll bring up second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Second and 15 now. Jackson.
That one complete to Prochet.
And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown.
James Prochet.
66 yards. And the Ravens have retaken the lead. So now an extra point doesn't help much. They'll try to go for two to make the difference a field goal, and they can lead it by three. Oh, look at this. They're not even going to get the two-point play off. Maybe too much indecision. It's going to cost them 5 yards.
This certainly feels like they were wanting to go for two, but weren't really sure they should go for two. Do we, don't we, do we, don't we? And guess what ends up happening?
5 yard penalty.
That's right. Now you probably line up and kick the extra point.
So now an extra point doesn't help much. They'll try to go for two to make the difference a field goal, and they can lead it by three.
A 2-point conversion.
Jackson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Oh, a mistake there. The kickoff out of bounds.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
The Chiefs in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at the 40. He'll look to throw. A screen to Bell. Now Bell hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week of practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll go again with Dobbins. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. Now a second timeout called for by the defense, as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee, and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
A gain of 2 yards on the play. Brings up fourth down.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go to water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coerce. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time. Infrastructure, I don't got time. I could alter. We're talking about to protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up an item you choose. Many ties in the culture, hit you with them get ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing it so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top always gon' get something, the middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, out of the execution, think I need the solution. Maybe not should I do it, just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
You're burning out if you jump into the fire.
You burn it if you jump into the fire. I heard the flare gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my way.